Hi guys, this is Sushant, Kochar, and today we are going to talk about spiritual benefits of intermittent fasting. Yes, I know this channel is about bodybuilding and fitness and not about spirituality. But see, intermittent fasting is such an important topic for your body's health and your soul's health as well that I could not resist myself from creating one video on this. And I also felt that it is my responsibility as a human being that I should make one video, at least one video, for the spiritual aspects of intermittent fasting, even if this channel is about bodybuilding and fitness. I would insist that you watch the video. It should help you, and if you share with your family and friends, it will help them as well. Okay, so see, when you do intermittent fasting, you are doing a lot of things for your body's health, but at the same time you are doing a lot of things for your soul's health, your spiritual being's health, your spirit's health, the soul that is inside your body. So first thing, intermittent fasting helps you control your senses, restrain your senses. Now, what are senses? There are five senses in the body: skin, tongue, nose, eyes, ears. Now, if you have seen people, that people do not have control over their senses. What does that mean? You might have seen people who just want to keep eating because they want to give taste to their tongue. They just keep running after food: pizza, burger, chow mein, manchurian, fried rice, momos, and spicy food, sweet food, just food. They are kind of slaves of their own tongue. That is one sense out of the five senses. So they are kind of a slave of their own tongue. Their tongue wants food, their tongue wants taste, and they keep giving it taste because they cannot resist, they cannot control their tongue, and they end up getting fat, they end up getting diseases because of all of that slavery that they did for their tongue. Same can be seen as people who want to give pleasure to their skin. They do a lot of things for giving pleasure to their skin. A lot of people just want to get massage on a regular basis because they want to give pleasure to their skin. Then there are some people who want fragrance around them most of the time because they want to give pleasure to their nose. Then there are some people who want to listen to music almost all the time because they want to give pleasure to their ears. Then there are people who just want to keep looking at really nice, beautiful, and eye-pleasing things, giving pleasure to their eyes. See, your senses demand for something, but if you cannot control your senses, if you cannot restrain your senses, then you would be kind of bowing in front of your senses, and you will be like a slave to your senses. Just like the example I gave you, the person who's eating. Now, what intermittent fasting does is, once you start doing intermittent fasting, so in intermittent fasting, you're controlling the amount of food that you eat. In a particular time frame, you'll not be eating, and in another time frame, you'll be eating. So, for example, in a day, you are not eating for 16 to 18 hours, and you're eating for rest of the 6 to 8 hours. Or in another way, you're not eating for 1 day a week or 2 days a week. You're doing 1 or 2 full day fasts a week. And there can be multiple other ways of intermittent fasting. Whichever way you take, intermittent fasting is going to help you restrain, control your senses. So, I have tried this on myself, I have seen people doing it, and this has come from our spiritual texts. As it is about spirituality, it has not come from science, it has come from spiritual texts. So, if you do it for 3, 4, 5 days, or maybe 8 to 10 days, whichever way it is, 16 to 8 fasting or 1 day whole fasting, whichever way of intermittent fasting is, you do it and you'll start to feel that now you are not craving so much for food, now you are not craving so much for pleasure of your senses, you are not a slave of them now, you are not worried because of your senses, you're not so if you just want to keep eating all the time because your tongue wants taste, then you're worried because you want to, you're bothered because you have something to do, you have to eat something. Once you finish eating it, Now you, after 2 hours, you want, your tongue wants more taste. So it is a feeling of discomfort because you are always after something. So doing intermittent fasting just for a few days, you would start to feel that you are now, you are naturally you are not willing to get so much pleasure out of food, get so much pleasure out of touch or ears or eyes. So you will naturally not crave for those sort of pleasures. So you would have more, that means you have more control over your senses. Now intermittent fasting, we call that in Indian culture, in Indian spiritual texts, we call it tapasya. And tapasya is basically bearing hardships. There are a lot of ways with which you can bear hardships. One of the ways is to put limit to your food, put constraints on your food. So that is what we do in intermittent fasting. Now, as this channel is about fitness and food related things, that is why we are talking about the intermittent fasting part of tapasya. So the part which deals with food. The bigger picture of tapasya deals with a lot of things where you bear hardship. But in this, we are talking about bearing hardships related to food, eating. Okay, now first thing, you get to control, you get control over your senses. Second thing, your kashaya gets lighter rather than getting heavier. So what are kashaya? Kashaya is a term used for a combined notion for anger, ego or pride, and deceit, cheating, betraying, and fourth one is greed. So anger, ego, betraying, deceit, cheating, and greed, these four combined are called kashaya. Now when you do intermittent fasting, your kashaya start to get lighter. So, and these are harmful for you. The more of these you have, the more you suffer. The more your body, the more your soul suffers. Both of them suffer. How? First of all, we'll see. See, if you are angry, let's say you are angry, oh, I'll beat that guy, I'll take revenge from him. You're angry. That means that you are kind of in a state where you are not enjoying this. You do not want to be angry for 24 hours. You want to be happy, laughing for 24 hours. That is a pleasurable state to be in. This is not a pleasurable state to be in. Anger, you do not want to be angry, but when you are angry, you are kind of worried, you are kind of unhappy, in an unhappy state. Our ancestor used to say that you will burn blood, burn your body's blood if you get anger. You definitely harm body, you lose your muscle when you are angry, when you are stressed. So you harm your body, you harm yourself when you are angry. When you have a lot of pride, okay, I am greater than this guy, I have more money, this guy is poor. When you have a lot of pride, a lot of ego, you kind of have a fear inside you that someone will disobey you, someone will give you disrespect. And when having that fear is one suffering, because you have some sort of fear in you. And second thing is that when someone disrespects you or disobey you, you start to panic. Oh, how dare he disobey me? How dare he disrespect me? So that sort of panicking is again a second sort of suffering, which came because of your ego. Third is deceit, cheating people. So when you cheat people, you have a fear of getting caught, that you have cheated someone, you have betrayed someone. First suffering is that fear. You have some sort of fear inside you that is giving you some sort of suffering. That fear is a suffering. And second thing is that when you cheat someone, when you do something wrong to someone, it comes back to you. When you cheat someone, someone is going to cheat you. When you betray someone, someone is going to betray you. When you hit someone, someone is going to hit you. So when you give someone some sort of suffering, that suffering is going to come back to you. Right now, if you are suffering, this is because you have made someone suffer in the past. So when that suffering comes back to you, when that betrayal comes back to you, you're going to suffer. Then again, that is a suffering. Now, the fourth one is greed. The greedy person wants more of something. I want more, 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 more. The greedy person wants more of something. That person, for his whole life, keeps running after either money or fame or anything, or maybe a girl, or maybe muscle, or maybe fat loss. That person might keep running after something, and as the person keeps running, there is no end to greed. If you are too rich, then you can be more rich than that, and if you are that much rich, then you can be more rich than that. So there is no end to greed. So you are kind of running towards running for infinite. You are kind of running to catch the end, to catch infinity, which is not possible. So first suffering is that you're running, that feeling of running, and that feeling of dissatisfaction, that feeling of not feeling contentment is a suffering. And second, when you do not gain something, because you were running after something and you do not gain something, that gives you sadness. When you lose something, you have a lot of possession and you are too possessive about it. So even if someone steals some money, some small amount of money from you, you will be very unhappy, sad. That feeling of losing or not gaining anything gives you sadness, and sadness is another suffering. So these four things, anger, ego, deceit, greed, these four things will make you suffer. These are combinedly called kashaya in Hindi. This is a Hindi word. Kashaya is a Hindi word. Now, when you do intermittent fasting, these start to get lighter. If you do intermittent fasting, even for just a few days, you will feel that you are not feeling so angry nowadays. You will feel that now you are not feeling so egoistic. You will feel that you are not... You have a tendency to not cheat people, to be a good, nice person, loyal person, honest person. You will feel that you are not feeling too greedy. You do not want to be running too much behind things. You would feel that your greediness has gone down. So basically, intermittent fasting would make you control all of these. Now, that is one thing. Now, controlling your senses and controlling your kashaya, all of these four things, will help you uplift your soul. The more you control your senses, the more you control your kashaya, the more you will be uplifting your soul. The more uncontrolled senses you have, the more uncontrolled kashaya you have, means that you are getting more karma binding to your soul. So you're accumulating more bad karma to your soul. So you do not want to do that. And the lighter the kashaya you have and the more control you have on your senses, the lesser the number of karma that you bind to your soul. And how getting mild kashaya, light kashaya, is helpful for us and others. See, it is helpful for us because we save ourselves from all the suffering that I just mentioned. And it is helpful for others because we do not give pain or suffering to others. If you are angry, you are angry on someone. You will be causing some sort of pain to that person's heart or body by your words or actions. If you are egoistic, then you will feel that, oh, I am better than this guy. So you will try to disrespect others. You will make them feel that they are something inferior. And then when you cheat someone, you are definitely harming someone. When you are too greedy, a guy who is too greedy can do anything to satisfy his greed, even if that harms other people. So a lot of rich people would try to gather money from poor people, or so greedy people make others suffer. So when your anger, ego, deceit, greed, these feelings are mild, you would not cause much pain to or suffering to others. Now, it is hard to win your kashaya in the order I just mentioned them. So it is harder to win ego than anger. It is harder to win deceit than ego. It is harder to win greed then deceit. Greed is the hardest to win, but intermittent fasting can help you win all of them slowly and steadily. So and I told you that having control over your senses, having mild kashaya will help you uplift your soul. Now your soul, when you do intermittent fasting, when you do tapasya, your soul gets rid of karma. The karma that are bound to your soul, they leave your soul, and that is when the upliftment of the soul happens. Now specifically for this, here you are getting rid of karma, and when you are controlling your senses or controlling your kashaya, you were stopping yourself from accumulating more karma. So there you are stopping yourself from accumulating more bad karma, and here you are getting rid of the already accumulated karma. All of these three things are happening because you are doing intermittent fasting. Okay, but in the third case, when you are getting rid of the karma, you have to, this is from spiritual texts, as this is a spiritual video. So when you are trying to get rid of karma, you have to take a vow, which we call kasam, sogan, pachkan, pratyakhan in Hindi. So in English we call it vow. You vow that, oh, I'll not do this. So you have to take a vow like, hey God, I'll not eat between this to this time frame, or I'll not eat and drink anything between this to this time frame. When you vow, you get rid of the already existing karma on your soul. If you do not vow, you will not be getting rid of much of the karma already accumulated, or maybe you do not get rid of the already accumulated karma at all, but you still get control over your senses, and still your kashaya get to get lighter, get milder. Now this spiritual topic is really different from what this channel is about. It is about fitness, but intermittent fasting is such an important topic that I felt the need to include this spiritual aspect of intermittent fasting on this channel, because intermittent fasting has both the benefits, benefits for body and your soul. Now I would request that you share it with your family and friends, especially with the people who are elderly, the people who are in older age, like 45 plus, or maybe 40 plus. You want to share especially with them, because it can be really beneficial for their body. And the people who are elder, above 40, 45 or 50 age, they also want to like be diving deep into the religious things or God related things. So you especially want to share it with them, if not for religious or spiritual purposes, especially for health purposes. So a person in the older age should not be eating too much. They should give more rest to their digestive system. And talking about me, yes, I do intermittent fasting on a regular basis. So I do around 14 to 16 hours of fast. So I'll eat my last meal before sunset, many times before sunset, like around 6:30 or 7 p.m. in the evening, and the next meal I will have at around after 9:30, 10 or 11, or maybe 11:30 a.m. in the morning, which is like 14 to 16 plus hours of fast. And I have gone up to continuous 3 days of fast only water. I have done continuous 2 days of fast only water, and I have done these two once, 3 days once, 2 days once, and I have done 1 day fasting, which is known as upvas in Hindi, multiple times, and I have seen the benefits of intermittent fasting on myself. And I do intend to and try to keep at least one upvas, at least one 1 day fast in 1 week. And I have plans to make it like 1 to 2 per week, but I do try and intend to keep at least one per week. I'm not doing it that continuously right now, but planning to do it continuously every week, consistently, in the upcoming time. So As this is a really important topic, I really insist that you should be sharing it. If you like this video, please like, comment and share. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.